This video is going to give us a short introduction into horizontal scaling. So we start off with a graph which has the following points. Now what we're going to do is we're going to look at a function g of x, which is actually f of 2x, and see what that does to the graph. Now the fact that we're multiplying by 2 may have us instinctively think that'll stretch the graph horizontally, because the change is on the input, so we know it's going to be a horizontal movement. We'll also plot the points x, g of x to confirm whatever we're thinking. So let's start by calculating g of negative 4, which is f of 2 times negative 4, or f of negative 8. Now there is no f of negative 8 here, so we can't find a point for this one, but if we do the same thing for g of negative 2, we get the point negative 2, negative 5. So as we've mentioned before, the change is on the input, so we didn't change the output, we changed its location. So this is going to move it horizontally. If we go in and do the rest and look at what happens, we actually end up with only 4 points out of all the points we had, and it kind of looks like they've been squeezed towards the middle, or towards where x equals 0. Let's take a look at what this looks like graphically. So here's the original graph again. And here's what happens with those new points. If you notice, they all have the same y values, it's just that they've been compressed by a factor of 1/2 towards the y-axis. They've gotten closer. It's as if we took the sides of the graph and pushed them towards the x-axis. So it's a little counterintuitive that when we multiply by a 2 inside the parentheses, we actually cut the x values by a factor of 1/2. Let's see if the reverse holds by checking f of 1/2 x. So if the reverse holds, we would expect this to stretch the graph. So we'll look at the x, g of x points. We can calculate g of negative 4 the same way. So f of 1/2 times negative 4 is f of negative 2, which we can calculate as negative 4. So we're going to be basically pulling that y value from the line below to get this point. Doing the rest, we get some points that we can plot. Notice the gaps now. The numbers have moved away from the y-axis. So graphically, here's our original, and we see that our graph has in fact been stretched horizontally by a factor of 2. All the y-values are twice as far away from the y-axis as they were before. So horizontal stretches and compressions are a little counterintuitive. When you see something happening on the input, it's opposite of what you intuitively expect. We saw that with horizontal shifts as well.